Good morning students, happy to meet you again. Today we are going to see some grammar part, how to use can and may. So let me just explain you. See, usage of may and can. So may, we use it in formal situation. What is formal situation? To your higher official or to your teacher, then you have to use may. To give and take permission, so either to give or take the permission. And second use is possibility. For example, may I come in? Often when you get inside the class, you ask the teachers, may I come in? So this is a formal situation. You are asking to your teacher. So this is to take the permission. Yes, you may. This is the answer from your teacher. So this is giving permission. Next example, may I get some maps? So you are asking the teacher, may I get some maps from the lab, geography lab or social lab? Yes, you may. So this is the answer you get from your teacher. So this is giving permission and this is taking permission. And another one usage is possibility. Okay, now let's see the example. It may rain today. This is possible. It may rain or may not rain. So you have to use may for possibility. He may come for the party. So I have used may. So he may come or may not come for the party. Now let's see the usage of can. Can also you can use it for taking or giving permission, but in informal situation. What is informal situation? Informal situation is nothing but when you speak to your friends or to your inferiors who is younger than you, then it is a informal situation. And it is also used in ability. It is also used in ability. So now let's see the example. Can I use your pen? So your friend is asking to you, can I use your pen? Then it is taking permission. Yes, you can. So this is answer from your friend. So it is giving permission. So we have seen taking permission and giving permission for can. Now let's see about ability. I can speak English fluently. Okay, this is your ability. So when you say about, speak about your ability, then you have to use can. I can swim, I can read. So these are all abilities. I hope you have understood. Now we are going to see how to express the unreal past, which action did not happen, but you wish that. Okay, what is the formula? Wish plus subject of the sentence plus past tense you have to use. Let me repeat it. Wish, the word wish should be there. Then the subject should be there. Subject of the sentence and then the past tense. Let me give you an example. I wish there was an AC coach. Do you remember this sentence in your textbook? This is said by Town Mouse. I wish there was an AC coach. But he did not travel in AC coach, but he wished that he had traveled in an AC coach. So I wish there was an AC coach. I wish, the word wish is there. Then you have to write the subject of the sentence and then you have to write the past tense. Now let me give another example. I wish I had a bike. Okay, so I don't have a bike, but I wished for it. So this is a formula, wish, then the subject, then the past tense you have to use. Had, past tense, but what is the present form of had? Has is a present form. Now, I wish I were a bird. Okay, so you want to fly. If I were a bird, then I would fly. So here, where is a past tense? Where is a past tense of are? Okay, I wish, then the subject, then you have to write the past form. I hope you have understood. Let's see the writing part. Okay, we are going to see how to write a description. So let me explain you how to write a description from Town Mouse angle. Do you remember Town Mouse traveled to the countryside and it felt uncomfortable and it returned to its town itself. Okay, so I have noted down the important words. So with these words, we are going to frame the sentences. See the first word. What is the first word? Sick. Sick is the first word. So you have to use only the first person when you write the description. Okay, so what is first person? I and we are first person. So you have to use those words. Okay, so the Town Mouse is speaking to us. Okay, it is describing its journey and its residence in the countryside. Okay, I was sick. The doctor advised me to take rest in the countryside for a week. So I went to my cousin's house. I went by train and I traveled in a train, and that was non-AC coach. So I felt very uncomfortable. I felt very thirsty. So I asked my cousin for orange juice or lemonade. But he said that he had only plain water, or if he wished, he would bring a coconut water. Okay, then he served me root and sugarcane for the dinner. I never used to eat raw food. So I nibbled the food and I completed my dinner. I did not like the dinner at all. Okay, then I slept on a hard, cold ground. I never used to sleep on the ground. I used to sleep on a bed. So I did not get sleep at all. The country was very silent, and I never used to that silence. And I returned to my town that day itself. So this is a description of the town mouse. I hope you have understood how to write the description. Thank you, students. Let's meet in the next session.